you want to take notes, your own quill pens are on your desk. Ooh. But why don't we tend to use them anymore?
Does anyone use a pen anymore? I don't even use a pen.
Do you not?
When did you last write something down? You type it.
Also, people, my mum is allergic to feathers.
And is she? She yeah. couldn't have written anything.
There used to be a name for that. That was called being illiterate.
Ah, no. My dad, my mum can actually write and read.
They were the writing instrument of choice for almost 1,500 years, but they required a lot of upkeep. So basically, not very efficient. You could write maybe 3 or 4 letters at a time, and then you'd run out of ink, and they regularly needed sharpening. So the pen part of a penknife... Anybody know where the word pen in penknife comes from?
Oh, from sharpening pens.
Yes, and it comes from penna, which is Latin for feather. So that is why we call it a penknife.
Oh, did you hear that? That was a lovely... Tell that to someone in a pub.
So, in order to make a quill pen, what you're going to have to do, first of all?
You're going to have to catch a bird.
Yes. It has to be a feather from a live bird, is the first thing. And then there's a hierarchy of quills. So, Jimmy, you've got the goose.
Is that like an everyday...
It is, I'm afraid. It's
working
common.
Pen.
Common a garden, that one.
When you say a live bird, it's not... Is it live for long? I mean,
Yeah. I mean, once you've plucked a bird's feather, it will grow back. It'll take about a year, probably, for it to grow back again.
So ye olde W.H. Smiths would have been just a bunch of birds and you're plucking feathers out one at a time.
Well,
I'll be back in a year for a refill.
There was a real problem in the 19th century. They began to experience a real shortage of quills. Why might that be?
Oh, avian flu or something, was it?
No, just more people could read and write, darling.
Very dark. I read a really interesting thing that Clive James wrote about typewriters. He said about the noise that writing used to make. Mm. So when he wrote his first memoir, he wrote it on a typewriter. It was a terrific racket all day long.
It was a phenomenal noise.
Ping yeah. every line.
And I still, that's a sign of my age, because I still do that when
really?
I
write. On an iPad, you'll do that.
Yeah, I know, it's very annoying.
I would like to have that effect when I press return, that it goes ting.
Do you
just
think?
So other people on the train in the quiet carriage would be
you know, when you hear people on their phone and they haven't turned the keypad tones on?
Yes. Oh, it's so endearing, isn't it?
Oh, that was a good noise as well.
To them, you know you can turn that off, don't you?
Do you? Are you bold like that?
Yeah, I just say, do you want me to do it for you?
Throw the phone at me.
Now, you've got a crow feather.
Oh, thanks.
These were for artistic people. They were specifically for drawing thin lines. Oh. So you might be doing an architectural drawing or some such thing.
You might be drawing my body. You get it.
You've got a swan quill.
Oh, lovely.
And that's only the best. So Elizabeth the First, she preferred swan. But the everyday one, Thomas Jefferson kept his own geese.
I was so pleased when I got given this, and now I feel like...
Jimmy.
Are you all right-handed?
Yeah, I'm right-handed, yeah.
You would need a quill from a left wing if you were right-handed, because you don't want the feather to be hitting you in the face.
That must have been awful, then, if they weren't killing the birds and they were just bald on one side. Just flying in circles going, well, this one still works.
If bald eagles lose a feather on one wing, they will shed it on the same one on the other side.
Wow.
Why might they do that?
Fashion.
Yes.
So, wait, so you pull out one, they pull out the other. That's fascinating.
Yeah, but what's that, though? What's that?
It's a seagull going to the library.
No, coming back from the library.
Oh, sorry. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.